healthy for a victim because the victim can get socially and emotionally bullied.
Being emotionally bullied is when the bully uses unkind words to bully the victim.
Being socially bullied is when a bully isolates the victim to make them feel lonely. Bullying is not healthy for the bully because the bully will feel guilty and may have trouble making friends, because who wants to have a bully as a friend?
Second of all, bullying can affect your future.
It affects the bullies and the victim's future because the victim may become a bully.
According to research, kids that are bullied are almost twice as likely to go on and bully others.
Also, the victim's confidence will go down because the victim will be made to feel scared, unimportant, and small.
Bullying affects the bully because people might not want to hire him or her because they might have heard of their bullying behavior.
Also, they might not want to let the bully to universities and colleges because of their bullying past.
Finally, bullying can lead to cyberbullying.
Cyberbullying is when small bullies use their technology, like iPads, phones, and laptops.
The difference between bullying and cyberbullying is that bullying is the face-to-face and repeated, while cyberbullying can occur just once, but the audience is much greater.
Bullying can lead to cyberbullying because the bully will want to hurt the victim more.
They can do this using technology and have an unlimited audience.
We hope that you agree that bullying is never okay at all. We also hope that you'll never become a bully.
Those fifth graders are being a bully to me could have started bullying and cyberbullying others, affecting their future negatively.
Remember that bullying is not healthy for the bully